ಅನುದಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್ ಕಸನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hello children, welcome to the English class of 8th standard third language. As usual, you are ready with your textbook, pen, pencil and notebook. Well children, today I have come up with a story for you. And our story is about a son and a blind old man. Okay, look at the picture. We can see two characters, a son and his father, old man. The father is blind. Blind means one who can't see. Okay? Well, children, a son took his old father to a restaurant for an evening dinner. Father, being very old and weak, while eating, dropped food on his shirt and trousers. Other diners watched him in disgust while his son was calm. After he finished eating, see, you can see a son taking his father to a restaurant for an evening dinner. Father, he is blind, he is old and he is weak also. While eating, he dropped food on his shirt and trousers. Then the other diners watched in him in disgust way. His son was not at all embarrassed. Quietly took him to the washroom, wiped the food particles, removed the stains, combed his hair and fitted his spectacles firmly when they came out. See here. Then, when his father dropped a food, what did he do? Yes, children. Yeah, the son took his father to a washroom because his father was weak. And his father was old and also blind, isn't it? So, what he did means, yeah, the entire restaurant, yeah. Then his son, he cleaned the food and dressed his father neatly and placed the spectacle. Then the entire restaurant was watching them in dead silent. First, the people in the restaurant, they were embarrassed. But the son, he didn't embarrassed, yeah, about his father. Yes, yes, you're right. Yes, and there was a dead silent in a restaurant. Not able to grasp how someone could embarrass themselves publicly like that. The son settled the bill and started walking out with his father. Yeah, after cleaning the clothes of the father, the son settled the bill and started walking outside with his father. At that time, an old man amongst the diners. In the diners, there were the old man. The old man called out the son and asked him, "Don't you think you have left something behind? ನಿಂಗೆ ಅನ್ಸಿಲ್ವ ಇಲ್ಲೇನೋ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗ್ತಿದೀಯಾ ಅಂತ. ಅಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮುದುಕ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಮಗನ ಕೇಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದ ಸನ್ ರಿಪ್ಲೈಡ್, "ನೋ ಸರ್, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವೆಂಟ್." ಅಗೇನ್, "ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ನಾನೇನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗ್ತಿಲ್ವಲ್ಲ, ಮೈ ಕ್ಯಾಬಿನ್ ಐ ಹೊಡ್ಕೋ ಜಾರ್ಯೋನ, ಕರ್ಕೊ ಬೇಟ ಬೋಲ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್, "Yes, you have. You left a lesson for every son and hope for every father." The old man, he said, "Yes, you have left a lesson for every son and hope for every father." The restaurant went silent. Yes, children, it is a lesson for everyone. We need to, as our parents take care of us, we need to take care of our children also. Next, let us move to the lesson. Today, we are going to look into the lesson number 4, that is Shravana Kumara. Yes, that is about Shravana Kumara. Well, children, let us look into the new words that come across in our lesson. Kavadi, a sling to carry weight on both the ends. A sling to carry weight on both the ends is known as kavadi. Look at the picture. Yeah, both the ends, a sling is used, no? Yes. Vendor carried vegetables in kavadi. You can see here. Vendor carried vegetables in kavadi. Yeah. Raju made kavadi to bring water in 2 pots. Fine, children. Next word, pilgrimage. Pilgrimage. A journey to holy place. While we are going to the holy place, we'll make a journey. Just we are moving to the temple and coming back, it's not a pilgrimage. For many days we will go, no? Yeah, it's a long journey, no? So, it is known as pilgrimage. You all might have seen at your home, your grandparents, even in your neighborhood, the elder ones, isn't it? They used to go on pilgrimage. My grandfather wanted to go on pilgrimage. Kashi, Amarnath temple, they used to go. And Muslims, they used to go for Makkah, Madina, Hajj Kartina. Save all this, pilgrimage. My grandfather wanted to go on pilgrimage. Then, she made a pilgrimage to Kashi. The usage of word, see here, she made a pilgrimage to Kashi. Well, children, the third word is thirsty. The third word is thirsty. Want of water. Want of water. We feel dried up here and we want to drink water. It is known as thirsty. I saw a thirsty sparrow at home. Look at the picture here. See here, a sparrow. I saw a sparrow thirsty at home. We feel very thirsty in summer. Dhupkale me, besiye kaalalli namge jaasti daaha agutalla. That is thirsty. Okay, fine, children. The third word is archery. Archery means the act of shooting with bow and arrow. Billu matte baanadinda baana birtivala. Yes, this act is known as archery. Ekalavya. Ekalavya was a good at archery. I love archery. I love archery. This is how we can make the usage of word archery in sentences. Accurate. The next word is accurate. Accurate means perfect. Adbhuta. Eno tappilde. Without error. Kaun si bhi galti nahi saka. Jo kaam perfect kar dena. That is known as accurate. Okay, let us see the usage of the word accurate. Our answers should be accurate. We should speak English accurately, isn't it? We should speak accurate English. Fine, children. Whatever we are speaking, it should be accurate. Fine, children. Let us move to the next word. Funeral pyre. A pile of wood for burning a dead body. Funeral pyre means a pile of wood for burning a dead body. Look here, the wood have been arranged here. Yeah, it is used to burn a dead body. So, okay, pyre. Okay, few religions follow the custom of funeral pyre. We all know, few religions, they follow the custom of funeral pyre. The widow leaped into the funeral pyre. Earlier, there was a ritual. When husband used to die, even the widow used to leap. The widow leaped into the funeral pyre. Okay, children, let us move to the next word, that is quench. Quench means to satisfy one's thirst. When we are feeling thirsty, we will drink. If we drink a cold water, thannigiro neer tumba dahide, at that time, cold iro water, matte hot iro water, erad riti water na kudithivi. ಆವಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಯಾವುದರಿಂದ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಯಾವ್ದು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತೆ? ತುಂಬ ದಾಹದಾಗ ಬಿಸಿ ನೀರು ಕುಡಿದಾಗ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತಾ, ಅಥವಾ ತಣ್ಣಗಿರೋ ನೀರು ಕುಡಿದಾಗ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತಾ? ಎಸ್, ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ವಾಟರ್. ದಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಂಚ್. ವೆಲ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್. ಹೌ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ ದ ಗರ್ಲ್, ಆ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಕ್ವೆಂಚ್ಡ್ ಹರ್ ಥ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಬೈ ಡ್ರಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಅಂಕಲ್ ಕ್ವೆಂಚ್ಡ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಥ್ರಸ್ಟ್ with tender coconut. Yeah, when some people they take tender coconut, they feel quenched. Okay, let us move to the next word. Anxiously means eagerly. Tumba kutuhaladinda kaita irtivalla, that is known as anxiously. The girl was anxiously waiting for results. The girl was anxiously waiting for results. Look at the picture. Children are anxiously waiting for gifts. Children are anxiously waiting for gifts. Okay, fine. Then, let us move to the text, children. Look at the screen. Later you can read in your textbooks. Shravana Kumara belonged to the time when Dasharatha ruled Ayodhya. Focus on highlighted words also. Shravana Kumara's parents were blind and poor. Shravana took care of them. Whenever they wanted to go anywhere, he would carry them in two baskets, kavadi. As time passed, Shravana Kumara's parents became old. Once they asked Shravana to take them on a pilgrimage. He took them to many places, carrying them in a kavadi. While he was going around holy places, he came to a river bank. Shravana parents loved that place as it was very pleasant to live. They decided to rest there for few days. Shravana built a small hut for their stay. One night, Shravana found that there was no drinking water in their hut, since his parents were thirsty. He told them that he would go and fetch some water from the river. He ran to the river in the darkness with a pot in his hand. He dipped the pot to fill it with water. Yes, children? Yeah, now it's your turn. You have to repeat after me. Shravana Kumara belonged to the time when Dasharatha ruled Ayodhya. Shravana Kumara's parents were blind and poor. Shravana took care of them. Whenever they wanted to go anywhere, he would carry them in two baskets covered each. As time passed, Shravana Kumara's parents became old. Once they asked Shravana to take them on a pilgrimage. He took them to many places, carrying them in a kavadi. While he was going round holy places, he came to a river bank. Shravana parents loved that place, as it was very pleasant to live. They decided to rest there for a few days. Shravana built a small hut for their stay. One night, Shravana found that there was no drinking water in their hut. Since his parents were thirsty, he told them that he would go and fetch some water from the river. He ran to the river in the darkness with a pot in his hand. He dipped the pot to fill it with water. Okay, children, for today this text is enough. Let us try to comprehend the lesson. Okay, are you ready? Fine, children. Look here. Yeah, Ayodhya. Yeah, Shravana. A boy Shravana belongs to the period of Dasharatha, who ruled Ayodhya. ದಶರಥ ರಾಜರಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಆ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು ಇವನು ಶ್ರವಣ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, See, look at that. Here, King Dasharatha. Ivana, Ivara Kaladali, Shravana Kumar Iddiddu. Okay. Next, what happened? Let us see. Shravana Kumara, his parents were blind. Shravana Kumara's parents were blind. And they were not able to see. Our ellandru hogbekagidre, the Shravana Kumara used to carry them on a kavadi. Kavadi agle nodidvalla navu. Yes, tabitis dekhena do baskets rati, ek lakdi rata hai. Yeah, on that Shravana Kumara used to carry for his parents wherever they wanted to go. One day, Shravana's parents wanted to see wherever he wanted to go, he used to see Nori. Like that he used to carry. One day, Shravana's parents, what they said? They told to Shravana, we want to visit many holy places. We want to go on a pilgrimage for holy places. Now, devasthanagalannella teerthayatrege navu hogbeku anta heltare. At that time, he took his parents while on a journey. They went to a place. It was very pleasant. Avaran jagakke hogtare adu tumba sundaravagirutte matte tumba prashantateinda koodirutte. It was very nice place. They wanted to rest it. Then Shravana, what? He built a hut for their parents. Then what happened? One day he found there was no water in a pot. Gadigeyalli neer kaanisalla. So what Shravana did? He took the pot. Gadige tokondu he went to the river to fetch the water. Neer tarlikke. Yeah, pani laane ke vaste ghada le leko. He go to river. Okay, let us see what happened next in our next class. Now it's time to recall the answers. Whose parents were blind and poor? Yes, children. Shravana Kumar's parents were blind and poor. Who ruled Ayodhya? Dasharatha ruled Ayodhya. Where Shravana take his parents? Shravana took his parents on a pilgrimage. Who were thirsty? Shravana's parents were thirsty. Very nice, children. The answers what you gave are right. Now let us move to a grammar fun. Common noun. Common noun andre yenu anodanna nodana. A common noun is a genus of person, place, animal or thing. Common noun is the generic name of, yes, person, place, animal or thing. Example, man, singer, baby. Yes, singer. Common agirutte adu. Singer, you may be singer, I may be singer. Anyone may be singer. Man. Yes. Then, common name of place. Hospital, school, bank. Yav hospital aladru agbodu. Yav school aladru agbodu. Yav bank aladru agbodu. So, that is a generic name of a animal, thing or person. Then, third one. Tiger, cow, dog. Animal means birds also come. Okay. Yes. Cow. Hasu. Astre. Then. Ball. Pen. Book. Think. Okay. A common noun is a generic name of person, place, animal or thing. Example for person, man, singer, doctor, lawyer. For place, hospital, school, bank, park, yes, hotel. For animal, tiger, cow, dog, peacock, yes. Ball, pen, book, car. Yeah. These generic names are known as common noun. Now, activity for you. See, read the words, write people, place, animal or thing. Iga, what you are supposed to do means, you have to read the below words and you have to write whether they are belongs to people, whether they belong to place, whether the words belong to animal or whether the words belong to thing. Okay, children? This is what now you are supposed to do. First, I will read it out. The first one. Bus, fan, bent, plate. Look them. Yeah, I think you are ready with answer. I'll read all. Teacher, doctor, uncle, driver. Yes, children, the first one, things. Second one, you are ready? Okay, people, fox, cat, lion, cow, animal. Hotel, post office, city, village, place. Pencil, bangle, ball, cake, things. Yeah. Bus, fan, bed, plate, things. Teacher, doctor, uncle, driver, people. Fox, cat, lion, cow, animal. Hotel, post office, city, village, place. Pencil, bangle, ball, cake, things. One more activity for you. Yes, children. Underline the common nouns in the below sentences. 5 sentences I have given for you. In those sentences, there are common nouns. You have to underline those words. I'll read out all the 5 sentences for you. The children are playing cricket. I saw a lotus floating in the pond. There are many parks in my city. My brother is 5 years old. My friends are reading interesting books. Okay? It may be singulars or it may be common nouns. Okay? Fine, children. Okay? They may be singulars in a sentence. They may be in plural form. You have to underline all the common nouns. Once again, you want me to read? The children are playing cricket. I saw a lotus floating in the pond. There are many parks in my city. My brother is 5 years old. My friends are reading interesting books. You have finished? Wow! Let us see the answers. Yeah, chill. In the first sentence, children cricket are the common nouns. In the second sentence, lotus pond, common nouns. In a third sentence, parks, city is the common noun. We don't know which park and we don't know which city. So, those nouns fall under common nouns. Brother, ears, very good children. Friends, books, yeah, whatever you have underlined and whatever the words highlighted in blue color are the common nouns. Now, it's a time for assignment. See children, today's assignment, easily you can do. Just what you are supposed to do means, you have to read the text in text. Don't read full text of Shravana Kumara. Just what we have done, para 1, para 2 and para 3. Only on 3 paragraphs. Okay. You have to read para 1, para 2 and para 3. You have to read the first 3 paragraphs and you have to list out the common nouns which comes there. Okay, children. Read the text and list out the common nouns that comes under the first 3 paragraphs. Then, children, now I hope you have enjoyed the session and you are eagerly waiting to read and to list out the common nouns after the class. Okay, children, this is B.B. Sahera, assistant teacher, GHPS Lachanakeri, Koppal Taluk and District. Take care, children. Bye, children.
Anudina, Anukshana, Maniyellu Kaliyona, Kalikeya Hosahadiyali, Jotegudi Hecheya Hakona, Santasadi Kaliyona, Namma Hemmeyayi Classinali.
Yes, sir.
Yes, teacher.
The same, ma'am.